Hi everyone, this is a refresher video on how to graph in Excel. In this video I'll show you how to plot your points, how to use a scatter plot, how to show the equation of a line, and the R-squared or the best fit correlation. So what I did for you already is just open up Excel, so I think most of you can find it. Now I'm just going to make up the data, but obviously use your data when you do this, of course depending on what you use. So for this video, I'm going to use a distance-time graph, but of course, this can apply to any sort of units. And I'm just going to do a very simple, basic kind of graph. I am using what is the most latest Windows, which I believe is Windows 10. So this is the version of Excel. So your buttons might be a little different, but generally, this is how you can do it. So let's pretend that, you know, you have some data and you want to graph it. So the first thing you want to do is put in your data. So like I said, I'm going to make up the coordinates here. Now, so what I usually do is, of course, I just like to label things. I have the value of measurement, which is distance, and then I usually put a little note of the units right there. Now, it's very important that you don't put units next to numbers because the program doesn't understand how to differentiate between numbers and letters, and they won't be able to graph. So, you know, pro tip here is make sure that you do not put units next to numbers. So let's say you have a distance time, just like this, and let's say that our distances are the following. Let's keep it pretty standard here. I'm going to do a lot of data points because the more data points, the better your graph turns out to be. Actually, I'm going to reverse this, which is fine. Just going to go ahead and do that. So say 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4 second, 5 second, 6 seconds. 8 seconds. And then let's say that these were your distances, okay? So these are in meters. So say, I want to add the zero mark because at zero time, there's 0 seconds. So that's important to add. So let's say that in 0 seconds, you were at 0.025 meters. And then let's say we're at 0.48 meters. And let's say that we're at 0.79 meters, and then this is 0.99. I'm purposely doing this with a little error in it. Let's say that this is 1.2 meters, that this is, let's see, 1.3 meters, and then this can be 1.52 meters. Okay, so notice that some of these decimal places don't have the same amount of decimals. So what you can do is you can highlight this so that you get the same number. So this button right here kind of sets the decimal place. So let's be consistent and let's use two decimal places. So this decreases, this increases, as you can see. So I'm just going to keep it pretty consistent. So something else you can do too, you don't have to do this, but if you make it look nice and neat, you can use those two buttons right there to kind of make them in a straight line column like this. Okay. So most of you would just highlight this and then press insert graph, but the problem with that is then Excel just guesses at what you want. So the way I'm going to show you the method is to tell Excel what you want. So I'm just going to click on an empty cell to make sure that it's not on any of this. And then these are the steps. So first I'm going to go to insert, and we're going to go to a graph. Now in physics we always want to do a scatter plot, okay? That's always the graph, not a line graph. I know a lot of times we go for a line graph. We want a scatter plot because usually there's some mathematical relationship and we want to calculate that. And in most cases, I want just the single dotted scatter plot. So this one without the lines or anything like that. And, you know, right now this is correct. It's blank. There's no data on this, which is fine. So like I said, you're going to actually select the data. So what you're going to do is go to this button that says select data. You can also get to this button by right-clicking, and you can see that you have the button Select Data, but this is just easier. So click on the graph, Select Data. Now, notice that there's nothing on here. You have to add the data, so you're going to click this button for Add. Series name, if you have multiple things on the graph, you would do this. Let's just call this car for right now, but that's what that means is, you know, if this is the car data, or this is the bike data, or this is the person data. So that's all that represents. And notice that this sets you up for X and Y. This is saying what's your X values. So to highlight your X values, you're actually going to press this button, and then you're going to highlight your X, which is in this case for this graph is time. Now, do not highlight the time itself, the word, because again, it doesn't like words. It just needs to work with numbers. Once you highlight it, it's got this funny code here. You can press the button, and now the code is there. It's selecting this row. And then same thing with the Y. You're going to press the button, and this is going to select this row. Just like that. Okay, perfect. Now, if I were to add another data set, if I wanted to do that, I would just go ahead and add, and this would be a new data set, like person, you know, and then you would highlight X and Y. But just for the time being, I'm not going to do that. But if you wanted to add, oops, I erased it all. Sorry, I'll just do it really quick. If you wanted to add another line to the graph, that's how you would do it. You would just press the button add. So let's fix that. There we go. So you see that car is there. You press OK. Everything's all set. And there's your graph. Now, there's a couple methods to do this. Now, first of all, notice that there's no units at all. So you could go to chart elements, and you can do axes titles. So what you can do is you can put them one here, axis title, one here, which is what you want. Very good. And then you would label it appropriately. This is time in seconds, so you want to match your data that you have right here. And this is distance in meters, just like that. And now you don't want to put car up here as a title. You want your title to accurately depict your data. So this is the time and distance. So this is distance versus time of a car moving along a level surface. So notice that title tells you exactly what this data is. So the more specific, the better. So you don't want to put things like, for example, speed, even though that is what the slope of this, because it's not showing you the speed of the cart at any time. It's displaying distance and time. Of course, you can play with lots of other things, but the last thing you're going to do is you're going to add a best fit. So you're going to, what you're going to do is right-click on the data. So notice that you have to pick a data point, and you have to right-click on the data. When you do, you get this option called Add Trend Line. So if you notice, it kind of defaults to linear, but if for whatever reason it wasn't picking linear, yes, it doesn't like that. Let's go back to linear, though. Add Trend Line, linear, perfect. And that's what I want you to do, is the best fit line. So after you do the best fit line, I'm just going to move my person because I'm kind of in the way here. So that's the best fit line. And if you scroll to the bottom, you have display, equation on chart, and R squared value. Now the equation in physics is always going to give us some information. So for example, the slope of this graph is going to be our speed. So the slope of the graph is equal to speed, as I kind of described in class. So if I asked you for the slope would be 0.2173. And if you want the units, it's the y versus the x, so it's meters per second. That's the slope. Now the other part is the y-intercept, which is usually this would be the beginning speed. So this is the initial speed. It should have been zero. It's pretty close to zero, but because our data is not perfect, you can see that our initial speed here, initial position. I'm sorry, I said speed. I meant position, because our y is actually position. My fault here. I'll tell you in class what these are if you need to know it. But anyway, the point is I'm reading the graph, so that's the y-intercept, and that would be zero meters. Sorry, like that. Anyway. So there you have it. So this R squared right here tells you how well the data fits to a line. How linear is it? So if I want you to read your R squared value, the R squared value is 0.9876. Now, what we're aiming for is how well the data fits to a line. It doesn't tell you how accurate your data is. Your data can be completely inaccurate and have a perfect line. So it doesn't tell you how accurate is, but it does tell you how close it is to the model of a line. So let me just show you really briefly some examples of random R squared. So I'm actually going to do a quick little chart over here then to show you what the R squared means. So say you have something like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that, and these are your numbers. Let's say it is a perfect matchup. So I'm going to show you an R squared of 1 and what that looks like. So you can see me do this in fast mode just so you can see quickly again how to do a chart. Again, don't worry about this part. Let's do X, Y, okay. And just for our, let's do trend line. And then, like I said, let's do this too. Okay. So if you notice, an R squared of 1 is a perfect fit. So take a look at this data right here. So that is a perfect line. So when we're modeling in physics, the closer we are to 1, the better the model is to a straight line. And usually the model has to do with a physical quantity. So for example, for this constant speed lab, R squared of 1 is a perfect line, which means it perfectly models constant speed, right? So looking at, like I said, I purposely put some like variance in this data. So 0.98 is actually very good. You know, you're getting, it's really good if it's 0.98, because you're, if you can see the data points here too, they're almost on a straight line. It's practically on a straight line. So the closer you are, like 0.99, 0.98, those are really good values to R squared. So what this translates to is this chart that we're looking at right now means it mostly fits a linear model, which means it's modeling constant speed. Now I put the word mostly fits because clearly it doesn't, all the points don't lie on the line, but most of them do. And then to talk about it, you would talk about where the points line relative to the best fit. If you're so lucky to do this, this perfectly fits. So R squared equals 1, this perfectly models linear constant motion, because that's what modeling constant motion looks like. Let me just show you what R squared of not zero, you know, I'm going to purposely make a really bad R squared so you can see the difference, okay? So instead of this nice relationship, let's do 10, let's do 100, you know, let's not make them too big because I want them to be all on the same chart. Okay, shortcut, if you ever have to make more than one graph, is you could just copy and paste and just reselect your data. So I'm going to reselect my X and my Y here. There we go. Okay, move myself out of the way. Okay, so here is an R squared, not of 1, but of 0.2942. Now, if you look at this, the data points are literally all over the place. So notice that your R squared is almost zero. It means there's no correlation between the data and the points like that. So this is a bad, you know, this would be a bad model. If this was your model of your object in motion, I would say it would not follow constant speed because there's different variances in this. And the data points, and they don't all make a line. They're nowhere near the line for the most part. So that's an R squared of zero. So, in summary, R squared closer to 1 is the best fit model. R squared to 0 does not fit model. Now, of course, there's some gray area between 0 and 1, so that's, you know, up to you, but usually you can see in the graph whether or not it's modeling the situation. Okay, coming back to this, this is what I expect in terms of a graph, appropriate title, appropriate time and distance labels, or whatever labels you use, the best fit line, the equation of the line, and R squared. This is what I expect at all times. You can play around with, if you want to play around with font and all that stuff, you can. You can make things look nice. If you want to go fancy, you can change the fill of this to a different color and all that fun stuff. That looks kind of nice. You can change the color of this line, you know, so, you know, I'm not too concerned with the colors, to be honest, but when it comes down to this is the model situation. So, of course, if you have any questions, let me know, but this is your tutorial on how to make a really good Excel graph. I hope this was helpful.